Hello everybody, it's John, and this is just an update on the channel to give you a little bit of information about where I stand. You may recall from the last video I mentioned that I was deployed with the Southern Baptist Disaster Relief Team, and I have been in Houston, Texas, Northeast Houston, for the past 8 or 9 days. Just returned home late last night, getting some things taken care of around the house for about 3 days, and then I'll turn around Sunday after church and I'll go back to Houston probably for quite a few days at that time. Some of you ask about exactly what we do and exactly what it's all about, and I don't want to go into all detail about that. There's plenty of information out on the web. You can look up Southern Baptist Convention Disaster Relief, and you'll see what's all involved and what all we do. But we respond to forest fires out west, tornadoes, floods, hurricanes, and we provide support for Red Cross workers and other workers that are out there doing some work. We have trained chainsaw crews. We have trained child care crews. We have trained chaplains that go out. We have trained assessors that go out to assess the damage and help people start the paperwork with their disaster recovery. And we also have feeding units. Feeding units is what I'm assigned to, and we support the workers that are in the area doing those other various jobs, as well as supporting the Red Cross. When you see on the Red Cross where they're delivering meals, typically those meals have been cooked by our group, Southern Baptist Convention, and we actually give those to the Red Cross to go around the community that they do have. It's a very it's a very enjoyable ministry. I really enjoy doing that, and I want to take you a little bit along on the things that we do when I deploy, being assigned to a feeding unit. Now, the unit that you're about to see, each state has their own units, and that is plural. There are many feeding units within the state of Texas. There are many laundry units within the state of Texas, and many shower units within the state of Texas. And typically within the state, you can be rotated back and forth, but I typically travel with the same group. Probably three-fourths of us are with the same group that we have. And the units, and each state has their own contingency, but each state pretty much follows the same format as far as the way the trailers are built, so that we can cooperate with other states. Right now, down in Houston, we've got several states that have come in to help us. I did get some questions about how we set up, and I'd just like to show you some of the day-to-day operations. So I'm going to do a little voiceover. These pictures were taken with my phone. And again, this is just a hiatus a little bit away from the ham radio videos and the machine shop videos. As I mentioned before, I just want to reiterate that this video here is just mostly for informational purposes. It's not really associated or endorsed by the Southern Baptist Texas Convention. It's just something that I'm putting up. This is the logo that you'll see on our cars, trucks, and buildings. We are in all 50 states. In fact, we're worldwide. The video that follows is just mostly a collection of odds and ends that I put together. Again, editing time was somewhat limited, so I'm just putting some video together to give you a background of what we have. First, I'll show you when I went to Houston. I went by my daughter's house and her family's home. This is taken from her driveway, and I'm just panning from left to right across the street and left to right of her house, just to show you some of the devastation. There was water here that was up to the street and into the homes, and this was Sunday, which was actually Saturday, which was about one day after the water had totally receded. So this just gives a glimpse of the devastation that we were working with. Here's the parking lot. We have just arrived with our facilities. In fact, there's some things that have not totally arrived at this time, but we're getting a lay of the parking area. We generally take up 4 to 5 acres, and you can see some guys out there as they're walking around surveying the area. We typically would like to have a church or a location that can facilitate us, that has good water and an ample amount of electrical supply to run all of our equipment. If we don't have that, we are fully self-contained. We can filter water, hundreds of gallons an hour of water, to purify that, and we have a huge electrical generator if we need to have a standalone operation if power were down. And we have been in areas where power is down. The blue trailer that you're looking at straight ahead, that contains two four-wheelers. that we use to ferry the food back and forth between the kitchen and to wherever it needs to go. But that's within maybe an hour of after we arrive and some of the things that we're doing. One of the first things we do after we determine the location is to power wash the area. This removes any small bits of gravel and rock so that we can roll our equipment across our ovens. All of our stuff is on wheels, so we need to have something that rolls real easily. Here you see a tent. Again, this is one of our smaller cooking units. It's a 20 by 30 tent, and we're in the process of getting it set up. It takes about 7 or 8 people to set the tent up, and we weight it down with buckets filled with water. So the thing doesn't blow away. You're looking at the back of a kitchen tent, our kitchen trailer. All of this equipment was in that trailer, plus much, much more. We have 2 convection ovens, 1 tilt skillet, and as I said, this kitchen has the capacity to easily do 5,000 meals a day, and if we push it hard, we can do about 8,500. There's the water filtration unit and our generating unit, our propane unit that's all together. Looking across right there, that's the wash station for the Cambros as the Red Cross comes back so that we can keep them spotless and sanitized and ready to go. The kitchen is getting more and more set up. We've got the tables now lined out, and some of the washing facility is a little bit more. This is inside the shower trailer. Sometimes we get asked, how do we take care of our personal needs? This is the shower trailer. This is the bunkhouse area. Most of the time when we go into a church, they will just clear out a specific room. The little blue cot right there is actually my cot that we have. We have about 10 guys in this room right here. The ladies will have a room off to themselves. And the church that we're at, Clay Road Baptist Church, was just an extremely gracious church for us to be in. This is actually the day that we started to cook. This is the tilt skillet. I don't know exactly what the guys are loading up right here, but what they're loading that in is a Cambro. A Cambro is a fancy ice chest. It will only drop about 1 degree an hour, so we can put food in it at 180 to 160 degrees, and it'll serve a couple of hours later at exactly that same temperature. Here we have ladies that are opening cans of stew that we'll cook with. And it's a machine. It truly is a machine going forward as we put the stuff in the skillet. And I'm not real sure how many gallons, about 40 to 50 gallons that we can cook in the tilt skillet as we get that ready to go. This is roast beef. That's about 600 pounds of roast beef that we're preparing. And this is pot roast. We're gonna have pot roast and rice and gravy for the folks. This is the four-wheelers I was talking about, and we're transferring the field Cambro, the ice chest, hot cold chest, whatever you call it. We carry that over to the Red Cross staging area. Here are some of the Red Cross trucks. They're called ERVs, Emergency Relief Vehicle. They're pretty much all the same. And we actually support the Red Cross with feeding. And they take this out to the community and to the shelters. The Red Cross really doesn't actually do the cooking. We do the cooking for the Red Cross to deliver. Here's the vehicle stage. They come in twice a day. We cook lunch and we cook dinner. And what they'll do is they'll come in at 10 o'clock and they'll pick up lunch, and they come in at 4 o'clock and pick up dinner. We generally start cooking somewhere between, we generally start cooking about 5 a.m. in the morning. So that means we have to get up much earlier than that, sometimes 3, 4, to get the kitchen ready and all the skillets and everything warmed up and ovens warmed up. This is just a little overview of the 18-wheelers that come in. We typically have anywhere from 3 to 4 18-wheelers. Right now you see only 2. We've got 2 that are coming in to stock up. They've already picked those up and are going back. Here's the forklifts that get the food out of the trucks. And this is a constant operation. There are forklifts that are loading food. We typically load a meal in advance. For example, if this is in the morning, and I'm not real sure what they're pulling out right now, supper, and they're getting that staged, they'll bring that to the kitchen, exactly how many cases of whatever we're cooking that we need, and they stage that for us. Once that truck arrives, we have logistics people that go in and they set the meals up on skids. So all the forklift driver has to do is just pick it up. Of course, when we receive it, it's no telling what's on that pallet. So we have to go in and we have logistic people that actually can tell us down to the serving, what's on the truck, what's in the ovens, what's in the skillet, and what's on the pallets. Those guys really work hard. They start very early in the morning and stay there late at night getting food ready for the next day. Thanks for watching, and keep these folks in Houston and Florida in your thoughts and prayers. Certainly appreciate it. And once again, I'm going to be on a small hiatus as we work through some of these disasters. I do have some videos queued up for the next couple of weeks. Then after that, probably not going to be any for at least a couple of weeks till I get back in the groove of things. So long, everyone. We'll see you back in the shop or back on the air. This is John, Tinker John, and W5CYF. So long, everybody.